Hi, I'm Kirsty making from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a nail, and I have no idea what it's called. It's basically embossed work, but it's done with gel polish, and they are coloured gel polishes, so I don't know. Tell me what you want to call it.
Coloured embossed gel polish nail.
Yeah. So I've already got an almond-shaped nail, and I'm going to use this colour for the base. This is just like a background colour. If I was using a natural nail, I would put on the Urban Graffiti base coat, but I'm not. I'm using an acrylic nail, so I can go straight on to that. It is a clean nail. I've cleaned it over. That's one thing that's super important, I think. You need to have a clean nail. Sometimes your client sits there like, and then you go to do the nails.
I do that.
And you put gel polish on and it goes a little bit crazy. It's like an oil slick. It's like when you put gel polish over something with oil on, because they've sat talking to you with their nails touching the face. So you've got to make sure they're clean before you put any gel polish on. This is great for spring. This is definitely a spring nail. I don't mean like boing, 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 spring. I mean like, you know, spring, the season. And all the blossom trees have started to get blossom on them. I love that. Where I live, the whole street has actually got blossom trees all the way down. And it's lovely when the blossom actually starts to fall. It's like confetti. Maybe we should do some blossom nails. Mm-hmm. Pop that in the lamp for me. I'm going to do two coats of that. I'm going to top coat at this point. Now that's cured. So I'm using the Urban Graffiti gel polish top coat. And pop that in. Now I'm going to take Serious Black. Put that onto a palette, and we're going to use that. I've got a short detailing brush, and this is what you're going to map out your design with. So we're going to do some filigree shapes, sort of like a comma, I suppose they are. I'm going to do it quite thin like that first, just so I know where I'm putting them. And then I'll add more. Now here we're going to do a rose, and this will just be like a stencil rose. So those of you that have watched the stencil rose video, you'll kind of know what I'm doing here. Those that haven't, you need to watch that video. So I'm just doing the outline. Pop me that in the lamp. I'm just going to cure that in, but what I'm going to do now is add more thickness to that design. So that's just my mapped out design. I've done it quite thin. I've only used a tiny amount of product. Now I'm going to do it a little bit thicker. So now I'm going to go over the top of what we've just done, making it a little bit thicker. So not only will you have more colour, you'll have a thicker edge. It's not super thick, it's just a little bit thicker. The most important part of this part is... That made no sense, did it? The most important part of this part, well, it does, kind of does, is to get the perimeter, so the outer part, neat. Don't worry about like the inside, because that will not be seen. So this is what we're working with now. Now I'm going to pop these colours on. I've got this sort of lemon colour, which is that purpley pink. And we have this like minty colour. Then we have this. Look how we can see the reflection of the light. Then we've got white, which is white on. It is 0001. Then we're going to take a detailing brush. I will flash cure between each one, so bear that in mind. Each change of colour, I need to clean my brush, so I'm going to get some of the gel residue wipe off solution, pop it into a dampened dish so I can keep cleaning it off.
Oh, this is like the app that you can colour in.
Painting by numbers. Flash.
Ah. Oh, that's going to get boring.
So now you might be able to see the reason that I sort of did it in black first, because the gel will sort of sit in those gaps. So it's like, it holds the gel. What about if we take a bit of that white and a bit of that? Make it lighter, mix it in. So you want to use just the tip of the brush so you don't flatten out the gel. Cure that. So I'm going to use this colour that I've mixed on these two. Then I will mix a slightly darker shade. Again, just using the very tip of the brush to move the gel out. You want to keep it raised. I'm going to use the same colour I've mixed on this part. Oh dear, got it on your skin. I'll have to fetch that off. Use the original colour now. And I'm going to make this a little bit darker by adding some of the black. You can leave it like that, but I'm going to put a little bit of Mega Gloss over the raised sections. Flash curing in between. So you can see that it's embossed, you can see that it's, you know, it's all raised, it's 3D. I need to wipe over with the gel residue wipe off solution, but to be honest, when I touch that, I can't actually feel any residue at all. So you probably could get away with not wiping it over. But I'm going to, because they are the rules. What it will do, it'll just take off a bit of the shine from the black, so it'll make it a little bit more matte. You do not need to top coat this now. This is perfectly fine to be worn like this. I quite like the fact that the black actually goes matte and everything else is shiny. Everything else is shiny, obviously, because we've put the Mega Gloss over the top to make it even more 3D. Now you can do any design like this. You don't have to do a rose with sort of filigree swirly things. You could do anything. You could do an emoji like this if you want to. Oh my God, I've just had an idea. We need to do emoji nails. Unicorn ones. So there you are. I hope you've enjoyed that video. Products we've used today are down below. As always, in the description box. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Have a look at my Facebook and Instagram as well. And I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye. So now you might be able to see the reason that I sort of did it in black first, because the gel will sort of sit in those gaps. So it's like, it holds the gel in that area. What would you call that? It's like a little cot, like a little...
Like a well.
Yeah, I suppose you make a well for it, don't you? And the perimeter is there. It's like a moat. Maybe not, because that's in, this is out. This is raised, not sunk
canal.
In.
What
a
canal.
The canal sunk in as well, isn't
it?
So it makes like a little pool area. So you can put the gel into it and it pools into that area. Yeah. Oh, I don't know if that works either, but.
Comment below.
Oh!